Hey y'all, Surf and Sapo here. Today is February 17th, 2020. I'm gonna cook something out of this cookbook right here, Justin Wilson Looking Back, a Cajun cookbook. I go through here and I look at all the different recipes, and I've tried quite a few, but this one sounded really interesting. It's called Stuffed Cucumbers. Go figure. But we're gonna try it out and we'll see what happens. Let's get started. Well, we have four cucumbers here. We're going to slice them long ways. And then we're going to throw them in that boiling hot water. Just like this. Drop them in. Boiling hot water. We're going to blanch them. As such. While they're parboiling, we're gonna go ahead and saute this onion, celery, mushrooms, a little bit of garlic, and some parsley. Just cook it till it's wilted down. They're blanched, and I've already taken the inside out of all those because it's kind of a pain, but I'm going to show you how to do it like this. And don't push too hard because you'll cut through the cucumber. Just something like that. And then just put it in there. They can be crowded. And then you just want to chop this up best you can. Put it in there. Okay. What we have in here is the filling from these, the inside of the cucumber. We have 1 cup of breadcrumbs seasoned, and some of those little shrimp that you find in the cans. So what we'll do, we'll get this mixture over here, and bring it over here, dump this up in there. Like that. And mix it up a little bit. Pretty watery. That's okay. I think when it hits the oven, it's gonna change everything. All right, we need to add some Worcestershire. A spoonful, heck. About like that. It has a good flavor. And then some hot sauce. Today I'm going to use Tabasco habanero. If you want it spicy, you can use Louisiana hot sauce, whatever you like. Come on, boy. Actually, you don't need much of this, so I'm going to go with that. If it needs more, it's okay. And since they were, you can add some more salt if you want. I'm not going to. All right. So, what you do now is pretty simple. You can imagine what we're going to do. We're going to take one of these, this one right here on the corner. All right. You're going to scoop some of this stuff out and just put it up in there. Like that. Stuffed. Not too high now. Okay. Put it back in there. And then before we bake it, we're going to hit it up with some Parmigiano on top. A lot. We want it to be nice and cheesy. So like that. So I'll do the rest. I'm going to bake them till the cheese turns brown. 350. And then we'll bring them back out and we'll check it out, and we'll do a taste test. There's one more part I forgot to tell y'all. This is 1/4 cup of dry white wine and 1/4 cup of water. You're going to pour it into the pan. And I guess that just helps them cook on the bottom. Kind of steams them. And then they soak up the wine, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, here they are. They're ready to put in the oven. So let's do that, and we'll be back. I took it out. I believe this is good enough. It's this one was higher up, so it cooked more than the rest. But they're all cooked, and it's quite hot. Still hot. I'm gonna let it rest, and we'll slice it up, one of them, and try it out. I guess you eat the whole thing. Yeah, it's soft now. Okay, it's my favorite part. Testing it. Gotta test it or y'all think I didn't like it. I cut one up. I let it cool off a little bit. It's still kind of hot. Let's see what happens. Mmm. That's good. What it tastes, it just tastes like a zucchini, but a nice firm shell. You know, zucchini is very soft, and if you scoop it out, it's just soft. This shell is perfect. Mmm. Mmm. That's good, folks. You got to make this. You have to make this. I will be putting this on my recipe from now on. Have another one. Mmm. I mean, a cucumber is just a squash anyway. So, it's good. It's delicious. Utterly delicious. Go ahead and copy the recipe. It's in the description. And you can change it up however you want. Whatever you want, okay? But appreciate y'all being here. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and share this video, like it, and comment. And I'll comment back when I can. All right. Well, thanks for watching again. See y'all next time. God bless you and adios, amigos.